Yo, you know when you do your makeup and you think you look cute as fuck, and then you get in your car and you're like, bitch, what the fuck? We are at the thrift. The thrift stores opened a few weeks ago, and I'm drinking my matcha. I'm literally just gonna look at everything. Something about thrifting is just so therapeutic, and I haven't been in so long. Also, I'm gonna try not to buy a slip dress or just like random shit. Oh, this is kind of a vibe. All right, so I'm in shoes right now, and guys, this thrift store is looking bare, like very slim choices. It looks like it was heavily picked over, but I'm sure they just didn't have a lot of inventory because of what's been going on. But yeah, I'm in the shoes because I thought it'd be an easy place to look at, but there really ain't much. I always like to go through the shoes and the bags first because they're kind of just easiest to look at and kind of easy to pick out things, but I'm gonna head to men's t-shirts. This is pretty much the best t-shirt I've found so far, and it's like a Nike football club tee. But even then, it's like $7.50, which is like pretty pricey for an old t-shirt, if you know what I mean. I'm looking at the prices on a lot of these, and they're really expensive. And I mean, I kind of understand, especially with the quarantine, so I'm sure everything is gonna be a little bit more expensive, but still, like, it's fucking $9 for just like a basic navy t-shirt. I never have any luck, so. Men's hoodies, wrong season, but. Found this Adidas and this gray one, but they're both $13. I'm gonna try not to buy a slip dress. I'm in the sleepwear section, and I thought I found a really cool piece. I saw this and I thought it was like tie-dye, but in the front is Star Wars. So, not to buy. Ooh, this is a little spicy from Victoria's Secret. I don't know if it's too much, you know. I found these Wrangler jeans, and they look like they have a pretty small waist and they will fit me. There's no fitting rooms, so rundown of today's fit. Champion crew neck, biker shorts, Nike shock bag, Balenciaga. Of course, got my face mask on. Guys, you know what's so crazy? So I'm like noticing a lot of people aren't following the social distancing of like 2 meters, 6 feet. And there's like these middle-aged women just like pulling up next to me, and they start like swifting through like clothes, and I'm standing like right next to them. And I'm like, lady, I assure you, we do not have the same taste in clothing. Some baby tees that I found. I don't know if I'm gonna get them. So the first one is this Calvin Klein's jeans, and this, if you guys remember, this Paul Frank tee, which is actually really cute. I might actually cop. It's just like the Paul Frank tee, and I used to be so obsessed with Paul Frank. I found. First things first, sanitize. Sanitize that bitch. I'm gonna take off my mask. Oh my god, I can breathe. And for those of you who are like dying to go thrifting, I'm gonna be honest with you, it really wasn't worth it. I don't know if it was just the thrift store that I went to today. I think I'm going to hit up another thrift store on my way back. Fuck it, I might as well. We're at the second thrift. Hopefully I have better luck at this one. It's a different location in a different city, so. Gotta get the mask on.
Right off the bat, I found this like Burberry bag. I'm not sure if it's of its authenticity, but it's $11.49. It's a really cute bag. I think I'm just gonna hang on to it. Alright, so in the boys section, I found these three tops, thinking that I can DIY something with it. Then I found this like Nike vintage, $4. So I'm gonna call it hella vintage. If you guys didn't already know, like, these are so sought after right now. Not this specific color, but I still think it's cute for $4. Can't go wrong. And then I found like this vintage Adidas top. And again, I might try to DIY this into like a bag or something, but we'll see. And then also just found these peeking through, and they look like they would fit really nicely, and they're a good wash too, and they have like this on the butt. Don't skip the boys section if you're a girl. Like, I found this Adidas top. I'm not gonna cop it, but it's $5.49, size large, so it'll fit like a small to medium woman's. How cute is like this art deco kind of container? I found this in the men's section, and it's kind of dope, but the color of the shirt looks like poo. Another bag! Oh my god, I am done thrifting. I'm so glad that I went to this location. All of the goodies. So the first thing that I picked up is this top. It smells like somebody's grandma, but I've been seeing a lot of like kind of graffiti graphics like this. I think this paired with like some leather pants might be a really edgy look. It's not really my style, but I don't know. I need to like get out of my comfort zone. My comfort zone is like gray crew necks with fucking biker shorts, which is so basic. It's mad cute. So I scored in the men's jeans. Honestly, if I ever find men's jeans, I always pick them up if they fit me. So this is a pair of black Wrangler jeans. I think they're gonna be a little bit cropped. I don't know how I feel about that. So I might end up cutting these into shorts. I love picking up denim from the thrift store because it's always such great quality. And I didn't try them on in store, but I just like had a feeling that they would fit. The last item that I picked up from that store is this picture frame. Yeah, I really didn't have much luck. Like, I found a lot of cool pieces, but I knew I wasn't gonna wear them. But yeah, I thought this picture frame was just really cool. I love the shape. I don't know, I just thought it was different, and I like how it's like a gunmetal gray. All right, so this next thrift store, I walked in and this was the first thing that I got, and I was like, hey, take some time in the store because you're gonna find some good shit. So I picked up this Burberry bag. Now, I'm not sure of its authenticity, but to be fair, it was like a $10 bag. How freaking cute. And it's in really good condition. The only thing is like the straps are a little bit, I don't know. Really good size tote bag. It's not too big, so it's very like vintage vibes. Like, look at how cute that shit is. Like, love thrifting designer handbags because it's usually something I would never actually save up money to buy. I would never buy this. I would never buy this style of bag, but it was $10 at the thrift. Ooh, thumbnail. So the next few pieces I picked up are from the boys section. You guys will see this in the vlog, but shit was so expensive for like basic t-shirts. Like, a Puma t-shirt I think was like $10, and honestly you can get a brand new Puma t-shirt from Winners for about like $12. So Value Village was taxing, and like stuff like that, if it was like $3-$4, I'd probably pick up just to wear around the house and just like cozy t-shirts, but that shit was mad expensive. So I got blessed in the boys section. Do not skip the boys section. So this first item is this Nike jersey. I think I'm gonna rework this into like a tank top that fits better because I'm not really into like this cutoff vibe. This next piece I picked up is this vintage Nike hoodie. This logo right here is so sought after right now. Like, I see people reselling these sweaters for like $300-$400. And guys, I picked this up for $4, and it's in pretty beat condition. I might dye it all black, potentially. We'll see. I also found a pair of jeans in the boys section, and I tried these ones in store over my shorts, and they look so good.
and they just have like natural distressing, like whoever wore them loved these jeans. But yeah, and this is what the back looks like. It's the brand Request Forever. I don't know, it's got this like a little American flag stripes on the back. I thought they were cute, and again, you can't pass up good denim. I also found this little teeny tiny kind of like bowling bag, mini bag. It's a handbag, and I've been looking for something like this that isn't a crossbody, and I just think this is really cute. Very like high fashion with the mini bags, but this one's more practical because I can actually fit things in this. Like, this is big enough to fit my phone. It's like a nylon bag, and this is exactly what I was looking for. So the next few items are housewares stuff. So I found this seashell disc, tray, catch-all, dish, and it's so cute. This came in a pack of four, so I will be selling the other ones on my Depop. So if you guys are interested, I will leave them linked in the description. But yeah, I just thought this would be a really cute tray to like throw your earrings, your keys, your chapstick, your lipstick. Found this vase. It's like a very art deco vibes. I've been seeing this all over Pinterest, and this was $2, so I said, fuck it, might as well pick it up because it's mad cute. I don't know what I'll use it for, but... And then I picked up this vase, and it just has like these really dainty flowers on it, and I thought it was really cute. It's like a peachy kind of color. And this was $2 as well. And the last item that I picked up is this frame. Really cool frame. Again, it has rounded edges and then ribs at the front. And then it's a two-tone metal, gold and silver. And I'm so, so obsessed. God, I have missed thrifting so much. And I'm sure a lot of you out there feel that too. It was very therapeutic. So that wraps up today's video. I hope you guys enjoyed watching it. If you guys like this video, then give it a thumbs up, leave a comment down below, subscribe, do whatever the fuck you want to do, and I'll catch you guys in the next video.